An invasive species is a plant that is not native to the area and has an aggressive growing habit. It displaces native plant species, which disrupts the natural ecosystem, affects wildlife habitat, can affect things like agricultural production. They're very aggressive. Most of them readily reseed themselves and can outcompete native plants. There's much more productivity in the environment from the native species. You have to be persistent to control invasive species. If they've been established for some time, just removing the plants that are present on the landscape probably won't solve the problem. They're probably going to come back from seed in subsequent years. You'll need to continually monitor areas where you've treated and continually remove the invasive species plants as they reappear. You should care about the control of invasive species because of their aggressive nature to take over your environment or in your community, your open spaces, your green spaces. We're in a park in an urban area. We're at the edge of the park. We're going to look at some non-native invasive species that we found right here in this urban setting. The first one we have here that I want to point out is the bush honeysuckle. It's a species that was brought here as an ornamental. They reseed themselves readily and can easily take over an area. We see it a lot of times as the understory in wooded settings. We've got a plant right here. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it so we can see it better. This is called garlic mustard, and it can be quite invasive itself. You can oftentimes go into a wooded edge of a woodland, and this would be about the only thing growing. Groups that manage areas oftentimes will get a group together and have garlic mustard pulling events where they just go into an area and just start pulling it. But no matter how you control it, most of these invasives require continuous effort to eliminate them. Poison hemlock, which is this real lacy-leaved plant. Here's one that's a little bit farther along. It hasn't flowered out yet. It'll have a white flower on it, kind of an umbrella-shaped flower head. A plant that was brought over for ornamental reasons as much as anything. It is a toxic plant. Any part of it is toxic. If you get the sap on you, some people are more sensitive to it than others, and it may break out in blisters or a rash of sorts. I certainly don't want to consume it. It can be controlled with mowing, herbicides and things like that. We also have Multiflora Rose. Most people are familiar with Multiflora Rose. Oftentimes it's seen in pastures, again on woodland edges, field edges. Another non-native that's invasive can take over an area just like the bush honeysuckle can. These non-native invasive plants, their habitat value to wildlife is lesser than native plants. The fruits they produce, although wildlife may eat them, it's not of the greatest nutritional value. Native plants provide better nutritional value than the invasives. Here we're in a wooded setting, more of a rural environment here, among a more or less mature forest. And we can see invasive species, again, all around us. I've got in my right hand here a privet bush. It's shading out an area here. That shade eliminates the reproduction of a lot of native species, not just plant species and wildflowers that we might see here otherwise, but it also is detrimental to the reproduction of trees in the area. We don't get oak reproduction or hickory reproduction. Those are two species that are very important to wildlife and economically important. We're still in a wooded setting, but here's an area where sunlight is able to hit the ground. You can see there's some native species coming in here. We've got ash trees, we've got jewelweed over here, there's a pawpaw tree back here, Virginia creeper. Those are native species, but just a couple feet off the path here, we've got more of the privet. And if we pull back the privet, you can see underneath where the ground is not getting sunlight, and there's virtually no plants there. So that gives you a good illustration of what these non-native and invasive plants can do as far as keeping native vegetation from growing.